Chapter 9 Animal Life. Think and make a list of all the ways in which animals are useful to us. Compare your list with your partner's. Discuss it with your teacher. You know that plants are the only living things that can make their own food. Animals, directly or indirectly, depend on plants for their food. We can see this clearly in a food chain. Food chains. All living things are a part of food chain. A food chain shows who is eating whom or what. It shows how each living thing gets its food. Food chains have such arrows. The arrow means is eaten by. Each link in the food chain is food for the next link. A food chain always starts with a plant and ends with an animal. First, green plants are called producers because they can make their own food. They are able to use sunlight energy from the sun to produce food, sugar from carbon dioxide and water. Second, animals are called consumers because they eat plants or other animals. Animals that eat only plants are called herbivores. For example, cow, deer, and elephant. They are called the primary consumers. Animals that eat other animals are called carnivores. For example, the lion, tiger, and eagle. They are called the secondary consumers. Animals and people who eat both animals and plants are called omnivores. For example, human, dogs, and bears. The decomposers, bacteria and fungi, which feed on decaying matter. The decomposers speed up the decaying process that releases minerals and mineral salts back into the food chain for absorption by plants as nutrients. As animals eat more than one thing, they can be part of more than one food chain. Therefore, in nature, several food chains are connected to each other. This forms a complex network of food chains. This network is known as the food web. Look at the following example of a food web. Activity time. Think of how food chains with at least three parts to each. Draw them in your notebook. Remember to label them. Interdependence. A food web shows us that all the plants and animals in nature are interdependent. A change in the size of the pollution of one kind of animal in a food chain will affect other kinds of animals. This interdependence of the populations within a food chain helps to maintain the balance in animal populations within a community. For example, if there are too many deer, there will be insufficient trees and shrubs for all of them to eat. Many deer will starve and die. The presence of fewer deer would give the trees and shrubs more time to grow to maturity and to multiply, but it would also mean that there is less food available for the lions to eat. Therefore, some lions will starve to death. When there are fewer lions, the deer population will increase. Similarly, when farmers use insecticides and pesticides to kill insects that destroy their crops, the chemicals not only kill the insects but also poison birds and frogs that eat these diseases because they are part of the same food chain. The insecticides and pesticides are absorbed by plants too and get stored in fruits and vegetables. When we eat these fruits and vegetables, our bodies also get poisoned. Left to itself, nature controls the populations of insects and pests. Bigger creatures such as birds, frogs, prey on smaller creatures. It is better to depend on such natural methods to control pests rather than to use pesticides. We can conserve nature's food chain by the following methods. Being careful not to use harmful pesticides and insecticides. Not destroying forest. Not killing animals. Wildlife and its protection. Wildlife include all plants and animals that live in the wild. Increase in human population has led to cutting down of more and more jungles to clear land for houses and for farming. We have encroached upon animal habitation. As a result, wild animals are losing their homes and dying. Why people kill wild animals? Many animals are killed by poachers in the jungles. Poachers are people who illegally kill animals and sell the products in the market for a high price. In spite of a ban on poaching, animals are frequently killed for their fur, skin, oil, bones, horns, teeth, and other parts. Polar bears are killed for their fur, elephants for their tusks, and rhinos for their horns. Tigers, deer, snakes, and crocodiles are killed for their skin. Whales are killed for oil. This oil is used in face creams. This has led many species of plants and animals to become extinct or to be on the verge of extinction. For example, there are very few rhinos left in the wild. The same is true for elephants and tigers in India. Activity time. Find the names of 5 animals that have become extinct. Also find out more about them, including how and when they become extinct. Fact. The dodo was a flightless bird. It was hunted so widely that in the year 1681, it became extinct. Now there are no more dodos on the earth. How we can protect wildlife? We need to consciously make an effort to preserve and protect plants and animals in their natural habitat. As we have seen, plants and animals constitute an important part of every food chain. Therefore, their survival is vital to maintain the balance in nature. Here are some measures that can be taken to protect wildlife. Setting up of national parks and wildlife sanctuaries in different parts of the country to save wildlife in their natural habitat. Jim Corbett National Park, Kaziranga National Park, and Sundarbans Biosphere Reserves are such places in India. Felling of trees and killing of wildlife in these forests is not permitted. Keeping a check on the growth of human population so that there is no shortage of resources. Banning the killing of rare or endangered animals. Banning the sale and export to products obtained from endangered animals. Fact. The Government of India launched Project Tiger 1973 and Project 11 Elephant in 1991 to 1992 to protect the tigers and tuskers respectively. In 2015, the number of tigers in India was estimated to be 2,226, which is considered to be an improvement. Undertaking afforestation and celebrating Vanam Mahotsavs, which promote the protection of forests in different parts of the country. Several national and international organizations are involved in the conservation of wildlife. They are the Worldwide Fund for Nature, WWF, International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, People for Ethical Treatment of Animals, PETA, United Nations Development Programme, UNDP, Crocodile Breeding and Management Training Research Institute, Domestic Animals and Their Use. Thousands of years ago, humans learned to tame some animals like the dog, cat, cow, horse, goat, and buffalo. They cared for them, fed them, and used them in various ways. These animals usually stay close to or with humans and are called domestic animals. Humans domesticated different animals for different purposes. Pets such as dogs, cats are kept for companionship. Dogs are also used to guard our houses and to guide the blind. Farm animals such as hens, cows, buffaloes, bullocks, goats and sheep called livestock are a source of food. They also help with work on the farm. Animals like cows, goats and buffaloes provide us milk from which a number of products like sweets, ghee, butter, curd, cheese and paneer are made. Goats and sheep are reared for their meat and hide and hence for their meat and eggs. Animals like the bullock and oxen help farmers to plow their fields, pull carts and transport loads. Their solid waste or dung is turned into manure to fertilize the soil, it is dried, mixed with hay and burnt as fuel, or mixed with water and turned into biogas or gobar gas. In many areas, cow dung is mixed with water and spread over the floor. It acts as a disinfectant and keeps insects away. Fish and other water animals found in rivers, seas, tanks, ponds and lakes are a source of food. The hair of sheep, goat and camel is sheared off and used to make wool. We use this wool to make shawls, blankets, carpets and other warm clothes. We use the skin of dead animals such as crocodiles, buffaloes, cows, camels and snakes to make leather for bags, shoes and other useful articles. We get silk from the silkworm. Some medicines are made from materials we get from animals. Activity time. Do people take care of the animals that they depend upon for various things? Discuss. Make a list of animals that live in the house with us. Draw pictures of these and say how they help or harm you. For example, mosquito bites. Keywords: extinct, no longer in existence. Companionship, a feeling of fellowship or friendship. Venom, poisonous liquid that some snakes, spiders, etc. produce when they bite or sting. Fang, a large sharp tooth of an animal or a snake. Exercises. A. Take the correct answer. First, the herbivores in a food chain are known as primary consumers. Second, in a food chain, fungi are known as decomposers. Third, pesticides is or are used to kill insects that destroy crop. Fourth, animal species which no longer exist are called extinct. Fifth, horses are used to pull carts. Sixth, cutting the wool off the sheep is called shearing. B. Write T for true and F for false statements. First, a food chain starts with plants. True. Second, tigers are primary consumers. False. Third, farm animals are also called livestock. True. Fourth, WWF is involved in the conservation of wildlife. True. Fifth, afforestation can help protect wildlife. True. Sixth, we get silk from the plants. False. Answer the following questions. First, what is a food chain? Give an example of a food chain. Second, why is using insecticides harmful? Third, illustrate with an example how there is interdependence in nature. Fourth, why do people kill wild animals? Fifth, what is the purpose of wildlife sanctuaries and national parks? Sixth, how are domestic animals useful to us? 7th, list 3 products that we get from the animals. Let's do fun. First, in the list of animals below, circle the animals used for transport in red, for food or other products in green, and those kept as pets in yellow. Some animals might be used for more than one purpose. Use more than one color for those. 2nd, find out the names of the 5 national parks, wildlife sanctuaries or biosphere reserves in India. Do a project on one of them. Give details about its location, the wildlife it supports and how big it is. Third, find out about organizations involved in wildlife preservation and protect like the WWF, PETA, CAWD and CIET. Share your findings in the class. Fourth, work in groups. Select an animal that is endangered and write about it. Each group should work on a different animal. Use the website www.iucnredist.org. For reference, present your work in the form of a chart. To the teacher, discuss with the students how animals are important for us and how human beings use the animals for their livelihood. Discuss some endangered animals and how we can prevent them from being extinct.